Thank you. Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namani Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Prachaline Nirvashari Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
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 Reading from Bhagavad Gita as it is, chapter 3, text number 24.
圣典博前梵歌第三章第二十四节。
Utsiti yorime loka. Utsiti yorime loka.
Utsiti yorime loka.
Makuryam karma chadaham.
Makuryam karma chadaham.
Sankarashya chakartavshyam.
Sankarashya chakartavshyam.
Upahanyam ima praja.
Upahanyam ima praja.
Utsiti yorime loka.
Utsiti yorime loka.
Nakuryam karma chadaham.
Nakuryam karma chadaham.
Sankarashya chakartashyam.
Sankarashya chakartashyam.
Upahanyam ima praja.
Upahanyam ima praja.
Utsiti yorime loka.
Utsiti yorime loka.
Nakuryam karma chedaham.
Nakuryam karma chedaham.
Sankarashya chakartashyam.
Sankarashya chakartashyam.
Upahanyam ima praja.
Upahanyam ima praja.
Utsite yorime loka.
Utsite yorime loka.
Nakurvam karma che aham.
Nakuryam karma che aham.
Sankarasya cha kartasyam.
Sankarasya cha kartasyam.
Upahanyam iman praya.
Upahanyam iman praya.
Utsite yorime loka.
Utsite yorime loka.
Nakurya karma chedaham.
Nakurya karma chedaham.
Sankarasya chakartasyam.
Sankarasya chakartasyam.
Upahanyam imah prajah.
Upahanyam imah prajah.
Ladies, Vaishnavis.
Utsi diori me loka. ime lokas.
Usineo ime lokas.
Nakuryam karas che aham.
Nakuryam karas che aham.
Sankaram yachakarasyam.
Sankarasya chakartasyam.
Upaham ya ima praja.
Upaham ya ima praja.
Usideryam me loka.
Usideryam me loka.
Nakurya karam korte jama.
Nakurya.
Nakurya karam korte jama.
Sankarasya katasya.
Sankarasya katasya.
Supinesyam matpaja.
Upanayam imadraya.
Utsideyo would be put into ruin.
Would be put into ruin.
Would be put
into ruin. All these.
All these.
Loka.
Loka.
World.
World.
世界.
Na.
Na.
Not.
Not.
Bu.
Bu.
Kuryam.
Kuryam.
I perform.
I perform.
我旅行
karma,
karma,
prescribed duties,
prescribed duties,
规定的职责,
chit,
chit,
if,
如果,
如果,
aham,
aham,
I,
I,
我,
我,
sankarasya,
sankarasya,
of unwanted population,
unwanted population,
不值得要的后代,
不值得要的后代,
cha,
cha,
and,
han,
han,
karta,
karta,
creator,
creator,
创造者,
创造者,
shyam,
shyam,
would be,
would be,
将会,
将会,
upahanyam,
upahanyam,
would destroy,
would destroy,
会毁灭,
会毁灭,
imam,
imam,
all these,
all these,
所有这些,
所有这些,
praja,
praja,
living entities,
living entities,
生物,
生物.
Translation: if I did not perform prescribed duties, all these worlds would be put into ruination. I would be the cause of creating unwanted population, and I would thereby destroy the peace of all living beings.
意味要是我不履行规定职责，所有这些世界 都将遭毁灭，我将是那要不得后代之根源，并由此毁灭众生的和平。
Maybe we'll just read the Chinese.
那就念中文，请英文的自己。Vanasankha是扰乱社会安定的要不得的后代，制定规范守则是为了防止社会动荡不安。 为了使人自动趋于平静和有组织，你在生活中取得灵性进步，至尊主 Krishna 降临时，你所当然要遵守这些规则，以确保这些重要规则的权威性和必要性。主是众生的父亲，如果生物被误导，责任就要间接地落到他身上。因此，每当大众无视这些规则，主便亲自。 亲自降临，重新把人类社会引上正途。然而，应该特别注意的是，我们虽然在跟随主，但切记不要模仿主。跟随和模仿不在同一个层次上。主在童年时举起高瓦丹山，我们模仿不了，因为这对人类来说是不可能的。我们要遵从他的教导，但任何时候都不要模仿他。 在圣典伯切瓦坦的第十篇第三十三章的第三十至三十一节诗确认，我们只应该遵从主的训示，遵从经主授权的仆人所给的训示。他们的训示对我们是绝对有益的。任何明智的人都会按训示去做，但是不应该试图模仿他们的行为，不应该试图模仿希瓦去喝毒海。我们应该时刻想到 Ishvara 的地位高于我们。Ishvara 是 真能控制太阳和月亮运行的生物，没有这种力量，就不能模仿能力超凡的Ishvara。 Shiva 吞下了一个汪洋时普通人哪怕喝一滴都会毙命的毒瘾。Shiva 的许多所谓奉献者醉心于吸取甘蔗、大麻和服用类似的兴奋剂。 却不知道这种模仿Shiva的行为只能招来死亡。同样，这些自称是主 Krishna 的奉献者，只顾模仿主的 Rasa Lila 爱情舞蹈，却忘了自己不能举起 Govardhan 山。最好只是遵从大能者的指示，不要去模仿他们，不要不具资格的占据他们的位置。
世界上有太多人不具至尊守神能量的神的化身。Om Mahjana Samaranda Sya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunilipandina Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Sabadandikam Bandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Parakamalam Shri Gurum Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sarvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Nitamscha He Krishna Karna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tata Kanchana Kaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpa Dharubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vyarevacha Patitanam Vaishnavibhyo namo namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinoda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama In this third chapter, Lord Krishna was describing about the position of a person who is self-realized.
在第三章里面，Krishna描述了呢，哪一样的人是叫做已经自我觉悟的人？
Lord Krishna explained that for a self-realized person, there's no duty to perform. He's not required to do anything.
主Krishna描述呢，已经自我觉悟的人呢，他就没有世俗的责任来进行了。
He has no material desires. He's not in want of anything.
然后呢，他也没有物质欲望，也不会想要任何东西。
But Lord Krishna explains that even though he's in a perfect position, perfectly realized, still he will engage in activities. Because he wants to set an example for others.
那Krishna就说呢，即使这个人已经自我觉悟了，没有任何物质欲望，但是他还是在进行活动，因为呢，他要给大众呢做以身作则示范。It's
important that the leaders of the society will show the right example to others.
在社会上的领导者呢，自己以身作则的模范是很重要，让社会大众来遵循。
Lord Krishna has described in another verse that whatever actions are performed by a great person, then will influence the actions of other people.
那 Krishna 在另外一个师姐有说到，就是说一个所谓伟大人物。 他所进行的活动呢，会是大众遵循的对象。
So it's very important that the leader should show the right example.
所以当领导者呢，自己以身作则的模范是非常重要的。
Of course, in the purport, Srila Prabhupada talks about the tendency for people to imitate the actions of leaders.
那在要旨里面，Prabhupada说了，这个人们的倾向是去模仿那些领导者或大人物。We
have to be intelligent to distinguish between when to follow the example of others and when we are simply imitating the example or the behavior of
others.那我们必须要足够的聪明来分辨，什么呢？是我们在遵循真正。
Just at the beginning of the class, we were singing the song Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. So this is a glorification of the pastimes of Radha and Krishna in the forest of Vrindavan.
就像呢，我们在刚刚先唱了这个 Radha Krishna 在Vrindavan的这个逍遥时光。
So people have the tendency to think, I also want to do like Krishna. I also want to have Rasa Lila, and I will also have my pastimes in the forest.
那人们有这种模仿的倾向，就会想说，我也要这些逍遥时光啊，跟 Krishna 一样啊，我也去森林里面跟这些女孩子逍遥啊。
And in this way, so many people become degraded and corrupted.
那因为这样模仿，很多人就变得堕落了，然后腐败。And
people may say, "Well, Krishna does it. Why shouldn't I do it?"
那就有人说，他们就说呢，那 Krishna 这么做，我为什么不能这么做？
But we point out that Krishna, we were seeing Gopi Jana Balaba Giri Baridari, that Krishna also picks up the Govardhan Hill.
但是我们也说到 Krishna 是 Gopi Jana Balaba。 那就是说 Krishna 也是不止跟牧女姑娘玩，但是他也举起了 Govardhan 山。
Before we can do like Krishna, if we want to follow Krishna's example, you have to also pick up Govardhan Hill.
如果我们想说跟 Krishna 一样这些跟随他的这些行为的话，那你也应该要可以举起 Govardhan 山呐。
So of course, only Krishna can pick up Govardhan Hill. No one can perform that activity except Krishna.
只有Krishna可以举起Govardhan山，没有人有这种能力可以这样做。And
the same example is given in relation to Lord Shiva.
同样的例子就是说跟Shiva的关系。That
Lord Shiva, the followers of Lord Shiva, they think, well, Lord Shiva smokes ganja, we can also smoke ganja.
那些Shiva的跟随者说Shiva在抽大麻，那我们也可以去抽大麻。
But Lord Shiva also could drink the ocean of poison.
但是呢，Shiva他可以去喝那个这个毒液的海洋啊，他可以喝那个毒。When
they were churning, when the demigods and the demons were churning the ocean of milk to produce the nectar, in the beginning they produced some poison, and they requested Lord Shiva to come and drink that poison.
那些神仙半仙在一个时候的，就是说要 创造这个牛奶甘露呢，但是他们在岛这个海洋原因，那个牛奶海洋是最开始出来的是毒液，那所以他们就要希望把这个毒把它喝掉。Because
Lord Shiva drank that ocean of poison, his throat became blue. He got the name Nilakanta.
因为希望喝了那个毒液呢，所以他的喉咙变成蓝色的，所以他有个名字叫Nilakanta。
And because he drank that poison, of course, his body became very hot from the poison.
那因为他喝了那个毒液，那他身体就是由于那个毒了，所以身体变得很热。
So you can see the moon crescent symbol of the moon on his head, which Lord Shiva wears decorating his head, that is to cool his body from the heat of the boys.
那我们看到希瓦的额头上有这个太阳的这个月亮的标志，这个是因为呢，他要把这个身体的这个毒液的热呢，给它降温，给它凉下来。
So we should understand the difference between following the example and imitating.
我必须要清楚了解什么是跟随他们的模范，什么是我们在模仿他们的。
Now, earlier in the Bhagavad Gita here, Arjuna was arguing to Krishna why he did not want to take part in the battle.
那在这个蛋哥最开始前面有，Arjuna在举出理由，为什么他不想去参加战争。
And one of the reasons why Arjuna didn't want to fight said, he said, if I fight, then the elders, all the heads of the family, the elderly men, they will all be killed in the battle. They will all die in the battle. And when the heads of the family are all dead, then the young men will become irreligious.
那一个家中的长者年纪年老的人呢被杀的话呢，这年轻的一辈就变成没有宗教性了。
The religious principles will be forgotten about. All of our culture will be lost.
那这样宗教原则还有我们的文化就会失落了。
Young people don't take care much about the culture from the elders.
年轻人倾向不去，不在乎这年纪大或年长的这种所谓文明文化。
And when the young man become degraded, then the young women follow them.
而年轻的男士堕落的话，年轻的女子也跟着堕落。
And when the young women become degraded, then the result is you get this unwanted progeny.
那如果年轻的女子堕落的话，这结果就会有不想要的后代出生了。
And it creates an inauspicious, unfortunate society.
那这样就会制造出不吉祥、不幸的社会。
So Lord, this was Arjuna's argument why he said, if I fight, this will be the result.
那这是阿朱娜的其中一个争论的理由，就是说，如果我去出战的话，这也会是出现的一个结果。But
Krishna is countering this and saying, no, if you don't fight, this will be the cause.
但是，Krishna对阿朱娜说了另外相反的理由，就是说，如果你不出战的话，这才会是这样的结果。Krishna
is saying, even he performs his duty, he doesn't need to do anything. Krishna is Bhagavan, he has all the wealth, he doesn't need to get any more money, he already has all the money. It's all his. He's not thinking about getting more, how to make more money. He already has everything. So he doesn't need to work, he doesn't need to do anything. But he does it to show the example to others.
那Krishna不需要去做任何事情，不需要工作，但是他去做呢，只是给人们这个模范。Because
he knows if he doesn't do it, then it will set a very bad example for the others.
因为他知道，如果他不去做的话，就会给别人坏模样。People
will say, "Well, Krishna doesn't work. Why should I work?"
那人们就会说，Krishna不用工作，为什么我要工作？
If everyone just sits in samadhi all day, nobody will work. So that's why Buddhism came out of India. Not Fajal too, the Buddhism.
Because
in the when Buddhism was being practiced in India, everything was stopping. There was no work being done. People were not farming anymore. There was nothing, no crops growing.
因为佛教当时在印度盛行的时候呢，社会上的活动都停了，也没有人去工作，然后也没有那些生产农作物的。Because
everyone was just in Somalia, I have to do my meditation.
因为大家都坐着在那边冥想，就说我必须要做我的这打坐冥想。So
it didn't create a very productive society.
这样就没有说出现一个具有生产力的社会。
So Lord Krishna is explaining that he works because he wants to show the right example to everyone.
So Krishna 就说他自己也出来工作，因为他要给大众一个模范。
And Lord Krishna knows that if he sets the wrong example, everyone will just follow him. They'll just do as he's doing.
因为 Krishna 知道，如果他自己呢，做了坏榜样，大家就会跟着他做。
So he is countering this argument of Arjuna.
所以他用这样子来把阿朱那的这个论点呢击败。
Arjuna was saying, if I fight, it will be the cause of the unwanted progeny. But Krishna said, no, if you don't fight, this will be the cause. Just the opposite.
那阿朱那就在那边争论的，就说如果出来作战的话呢，会造成社会那些不必要的后代的出生。但是 Krishna 说不是这样，如果你不出来作战，才会有这样的结果。
So you can see how important it is to be guided by the proper authorities.
所以这个可以看到呢，从这个正确的权威去引导啊，被他们引导是多么重要。
Of course, we know that earlier on Arjuna had surrendered to Krishna and said, "Now you're my, I'm your disciple. Please instruct me."
Because
Krishna is telling Arjuna about his mistakes, his wrong thinking.
所以 Krishna 就对阿朱那来说到说 Krishna 阿朱那的错误还有阿朱那错误的想法。
And Srila Prabhupada is mentioning how often we see people make this kind of mistake.
那 Prabhupada 也提到，就是我们常常看到人们是经常犯这种错误。
People are often misled into thinking somebody's God.
人们呢常常被误导，把 某一些人误认为神,
they're thinking some ordinary person to be an incarnation of God.
他们把某一些普通人呢，就是认为就是神。
Now, actually, all of the incarnations of the Lord are mentioned in the scriptures.
那这个所有主的各种化身呢，在经典上有描述的。
And they have to be identified by their proper, by the scriptural references. If somebody is an incarnation of God, it should be supported with scriptural reference. The place where they will appear will be mentioned.
同时对于这个主的化身会在哪里出现也是经典上描述了。
The name of their parent.
而且他们是谁。 他们的名字也是描述了,
and their particular activities, which are by which they're recognized as an incarnation.
还有他们某一些一个神的化身会有哪一些特定的特别的活动?
But in the Kali Yuga, people are not very well educated about these things.
但是在卡利年代，人们没有得到这些好的教育.
And we often see how ordinary men are as being an incarnation.
因此我们常见到有很多普通人在宣称他是神。
And then of course also we get people who just simply want to imitate, that they want to take the position of God, they want to do the same thing, they want to do these kind of activities just as the Lord was doing.
然后我们就看到呢，有人就想要模仿
So Krishna was giving examples. He mentioned first of all, he said kings like Janak Maharaj, that he was another great soul who was the father of Sita, the wife of the consort of Lord Ramachandra.
So, 就描述了这个国有一个国王是Janaka，他就是这个Sita的父亲，也就是Ram的这个伴侣，这个Sita的父亲。So
Krishna says that even kings like Janak Maharaj performed his duty.
So Krishna说呢，即使像Janaka这样伟大的国王，也是要履行他的职责。
He didn't have to do anything. He was a fully self-realized soul.
因为他也是一个完全觉悟的灵魂的，也不需要做任何事情。
But as a king, he has duties to perform.
但是因为是个国王，他也有他的责任要去履行。
So he wants to set the example for others.
所以他自己要以身作则，让别人来效仿。
As a king, it was his duty to maintain the kingdom and to look, make sure of all of his citizens were being looked after.
那因为是个国王，他的责任就是要去照料全国，然后照料那些臣民。
He would give charity to everyone.
甚至呢，布施给所有的人。
And he would perform sacrifices to please the Supreme Lord.
然后进行这祭祀牺牲来取悦至尊主。
And by doing these sacrifices, it ensured prosperity for all of his kingdom.
那由于进行祭祀牺牲呢，让国家得到这个繁荣。
So Krishna gives the example of Maharaj Janaka, and then he gives his own self as an example.
所以呢， Krishna 自己以身作则，这个国王 Janaka 呢，也是以身作则。
So this is, everyone has to work. There are duties to be performed. There are rules and regulations to be followed.
所以每个人都要去工作，要去履行自己的职责，然后去遵循那些规范、那些规矩。
Now sometimes Srila Prabhupada would be confronted with young people who would say, why do we need to have so many rules and regulations?
Prabhupada 常常面临到这些年轻人去问他说， 为什么我们有这么多的规矩，这些规范？
You know, if we are transcendental, if this is you know, such a wonderful process that we're becoming transcendental, it should mean that we are free of all of these rules and regulations.
那年轻人，那你就说啊，如果这是超然，那表示我们已经超越这些了，我们就不用受这些规矩规范的限制。
Srila Prabhupada, of course, was traveling in the world in the 1960s and 70s, and there were many young people who were very rebellious against the society.
那Prabhupada当时1960年代、70年代到世界各地去旅行。 传教的时候，面临的很多的年轻人，他们对当时是那些年轻人是反，这个
They were against all these rules and regulations.
他们都是很叛逆的，不遵循这些规矩啊，社会的规范。
They thought we should be free. We should be able to do whatever we like.
他们想我们是自由的，我们可以做我们想要的。
So they were appealing to Prabhupada. They would say to him, why should we have rules and regulations?
那他们就到Prabhupada面前去诉求，就说为什么我们要那些规矩规范？
Just like in a temple, you come to a temple, there's so many rules and so many things you have to do.
就好像一个人到庙里去，就有很多的规矩啊，很多事情要怎么样怎么样做。
So, sometimes, but Srila Prabhupada was very clear about this. He said, yes, we must be very organized. We have to have rules and regulations because we want to distribute this message of Krishna consciousness everywhere.
我们必定要是有规矩、有规范的，因为我们想要把这个 Krishna 知觉传到各地去。We
have to make a clear standard for people, let them know what is the proper behavior. Therefore, we see in the scriptures there are different things which we are told to do and things which we are told not to do.
因此呢，在经典里面有很清楚的告诉我们哪一些是该做，哪一些是不该做的。
Some people are often have uncooperative, rebellious. They don't like to be told what to do.
那人们经常这个倾向就是叛逆，不喜欢人家叫他怎么做怎么的。
But we should understand that the instructions of the scriptures are the words of God. They're divine words. They're coming from the Lord Himself.
但是我们必须要了解经典的训示，经典的描述是神自己的话语，是直接从神那儿所说。Just
like Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna Himself spoke these words.
就好像伯爵梵歌是 Krishna 自己讲述的话语。
Not just something which is made up. It's not just something authored the Bhagavad Gita. This is actual words of Lord Krishna.
伯爵梵歌不是说谁呀某个人去编撰出来，这是神是 Krishna 自己所讲的。
And these words are honored and respected all over the world.
那这个梵歌里面这些言语字词呢，是全世界在尊崇尊敬的。
Not only on this planet, even the sun god Krishna spoke this knowledge to the sun god Vivasvan. So even on the king of all planets, the sun planet, this knowledge was received.
而且这门知识不只是在这个地球上，甚至在其他星球，在那个太阳那边呢，太阳神 Vivasvan 呢也是。 聆听 Krishna 这样的传递这个知识。
It's for everyone, everywhere.
这个梵歌的知识是要传给每一个人，传到各地去的。
But of course, those who don't follow the scriptures, then they get the result.
所以必然的，那些不跟随经典，他们也会得到他们所谓应得的结果。
It's described in, I think it's the 17th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. That the result is they will never achieve the supreme destination, they will never get happiness, and they will never know success.
那他们那些不跟随经典的结果呢，是在伯爵梵歌第十七章有描述，那些人呢永远没有办法得到快乐，没有办法得到平静，也没办法成功或是任何的富裕。
Scriptures are there to guide us, to give us a better life.
经典是存在着来引导我们，让我们是真正有更好的生活。
We will see the results quickly.
当我们跟随经典的话，我们会很快的看到那些结果。
The results will be, we will become free from all anxiety. We will experience real peace and happiness.
那个结果是我们会没有焦虑，而且会真正的心平气和，这种平静。
We will become freed from the attachments which are bringing us so much anxiety, the lust and the greed and the anger.
我们会免于那一些让我们很多焦虑的这一些物欲啦，愤怒啊。
So Krishna is teaching us this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. To guide us, to give, to help us to come to the understand the truth.
So Krishna, 在伯爵梵歌的出现呢，是来引导我们，教导我们这个真理。
And he's teaching by his own example.
而且 Krishna 是以身作则这样的示范。
It's not just simply saying one thing and doing something else.
Krishna 不是说说是一回事，做另外一回事。
And he's encouraging everyone. To understand this knowledge, to follow his example.
Krishna 鼓励每个人来跟随这个知识，跟随他的模范。
So, any questions?
所以有没有任何问题？
We are explaining here about karma yoga. Yoga of action. By acting in the proper way, we can come to know Krishna. We have to act. You cannot stop activities for very long. The nature of the soul is to be active. We have to learn how to act on the proper, in the proper manner.
我们要学习要怎么样去所以很恰当的方式去活动
actions which will take us out from the material world.
而且学习那些活动让我们离开物质世界的活动
If we act in the wrong way, then these actions keep us entangled in the material world.
如果我们是错误的方式在行为的话那些行为就让我们更加在物质世界被捆住的
Yes, Prabhu, Hare Krishna.
You said that we have to follow the rules and regulations. I respect that, but what should be our main ultimate goal? The main aim, what should be our main aim?
Our main aim should be to surrender to Krishna.
我们最主要的目标是忠于会去臣服于 Krishna.
We see in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna concludes the Bhagavad Gita by telling Arjuna, and by telling Arjuna, he's telling all of us that we should surrender to him.
那我们从《博伽梵歌》里面看到 Krishna 对 Arjuna 说要向他臣服。 所以也 Krishna 是向我们说的，就是说我们要臣服于 Krishna.
That is the goal.
那是目标.
What does surrender mean?
那臣服的意思是什么？
Right, that has to be understood.
必须要了解什么叫做臣服.
You want to surrender? Oh, what does it doesn't? Okay, I surrender to Krishna.
就是说，说的啊，我跟 Krishna 臣服，我投降了。
We can do lip service, you know, we can speak. I'm devotee, I'm surrendered. But we have to do more than just only say it. We have to show it by our actions.
Right?
What does it mean to surrender? It means you have to accept everything which is favorable for Krishna's service.
臣服的意思就是说要去接受所有对于Krishna 服务Krishna有益处的有帮助的
Scriptures are there to guide us
经典在那来引导我们
to tell us what is favorable for Krishna's service.
那经典里面告诉我们哪一些是对于Krishna的服务是有帮助的，是顺意的。
We may think I want to offer meat, fish, and eggs to Krishna.
我们也许想，我想要来供奉肉啦、鱼啦，供给Krishna。
Let me give Krishna some cigarettes and whiskey.
请给Krishna 抽抽烟啦，给他喝威士忌呀。
Oh no, that's not. Authorized by the scriptures. Right, there are rules. What you can offer. Krishna himself says in the Bhagavad Gita what he likes. So we have to be guided by some authorities. Scriptures are there to guide us. Surrender means to accept what is favorable for Krishna and to give up what is not favorable for
Krishna.
So we get this information from the scriptures and we get the same information from the holy men, the devotees.
那我们这一些讯息规范呢, 从经典上得到这样的知识, 从圣人那边，从奉献者那边得到这些知识。
They say sadhu, shastra, and guru. They will all give the same opinion.
我们说到呢，sadhu，圣人呐，经典呐，guru，灵性导师，他们的意见，他们的看法是一致的。
If the guru says something different from the shastras and the sadhus, then he's not really good. There has to be the agreement between the three.
So these three must
Just like in Bhagavad Gita, in the 13th chapter, Lord Krishna was speaking about the soul, because there's some discussion sometimes. Is there one soul or is there two souls? There's Dvaita, the philosophy of Advaita and philosophy of Dvaita. One is the monist and the other is the dualist. People say one, they talk about the oneness, the Atma, the Brahman. And others, they talk about dualism. They say there's two, there's a Paramatma and the Atma.
所以呢，就坊间人们在谈的，就是说是一元论还是二元论，是只有一个神这个个体Atma呢，还是有包括这个二元的，包括这个超灵跟个体灵魂这种说法。
So, Krishna discusses this in the 13th chapter. He said, "Oh, this is discussed by the great sages, and it's also described in the scriptures."
所以呢，人们在讨论，那Krishna在这边讨论呢，就是说，这也是圣人们也是这么说的，在这边说到第十三章的部分。
He doesn't just simply say, "I'm God, I'm the supreme, I know everything."
Krishna 不是说我是神，我是至尊，我什么都知道。
But he says you have to look at the scriptures, you have to hear from the holy man, and you hear also from the spiritual teacher.
那Krishna在里面说了，你必须要去从经典上聆听，去从圣人那边聆听，还要去这个从灵性老师那边去聆听。
We need to have rules and regulations.
我们必须要有规矩跟规范。
We can't just make them up ourselves.
我们不可能自己来定规矩。
Just like you come to Taiwan, you can say, "I'm going to do what I like here in Taiwan. I'll make my own laws."
就好像你台湾不可能说我想怎么样就怎么样，我自己来定出自己的法律。
If you want to drive on the other side of the road from everyone else, you know, you get a problem.
如果你要逆向行车的话，你必定有问题呀，必定出问题。
We have to follow the laws. The country.
In the same way,
there's a universal law. We have to cooperate with that universal system. Just like in Taiwan, if you follow the laws of the government, then you live peacefully. In the same way, if you follow the laws of the universal government, you will live a peaceful
life.同样的道理，就是说，在台湾，你跟随台湾的法律的话，你就可以过得很平静。那宇宙的法律也是一样，我们跟着宇宙法律的这样规范去做的话，我们也可以活得很平静。But
if we act independently, without any regard for, then we get problems.
那如果我们独立行事呢，什么不在乎、不顾忌的话呢，我们就会自己掉入麻烦里。So
surrender means taking shelter of Lord Krishna, knowing that He's going to protect us.
臣服的意思就是托庇于 Krishna， 而且知道 Krishna 将会保护我们。
And recognizing that it's Lord Krishna who maintains us.
同时要看出来是 Krishna 在维系我们的。
We don't do it. It's not just only our hard work.
事情不是我们在进行在做的，不是我们心脏会动，是我们自己或是神给我们。
by the mercy of Krishna.
我们的生存或所有一切活动，包括心脏的跳动，都是 Krishna 的仁慈。
Prabhu, what is complete surrender? Is it a state of mind or action also, or both?
Both.
他问说什么叫做完全的臣服，是只是说心意上的臣服，还是包括行为行动上？
Yes, you have to use body, mind, and words in the service of the Supreme.
就是我们的身体、心意，还有我们的言语，完全为至尊主来服务。
Yeah, you may say, I would say, you may use the lip service. We may say, I am a surrendered, I am surrendered, I am a devotee. But if in our mind we're not thinking of Krishna, we're not serving, then there's something missing.
那就是说这身心意要合一，不是说嘴皮动动，就是说啊，我是臣服了，我是 Krishna 的奉献者，可是呢，心里没有想着 Krishna， 想着别的事情，做了别的事情，那样就不算。And
if in our mind we may be thinking of Krishna, but if we don't use our body in the service of Krishna, then that is also not good.
那或者呢，我们心意是想着 Krishna， 可是我们的身体没有为 Krishna 去做服务的话呢？ 没有臣服的话，那也不好。
So first thing is to fix the mind on Krishna, then use the body, the senses, in the service of Krishna.
所以首先呢，是让我们的心意专注在 Krishna， 然后接着是我们的身体来进行对 Krishna 的活动服务。
Particularly by chanting Hare Krishna.
特别是在念诵 Hare Krishna 这个部分。
Hare Krishna. Any other questions, comments?
有没有其他问题或意见？
Marsh, can you elaborate more about in the beginning you say it, Krishna say you don't fight to Arjuna, then there will be a wanted project. Just opposite from Arjuna thinking, what's the difference?
Well, we said in the beginning, Arjuna didn't, he had reasons why he did not want to fight. He was saying, it's not compassionate. We should be kind to everybody. And he was saying that I will get sinful reactions. He said I won't be able to enjoy. And then he said also about the killing of the elders in the family.
那主那又说了，就说出战呢，必须会杀到家里的长辈、家族中的人。All
the great generals have all come to fight.
所有家族中的这些伟大的将领都出战了。So
if they all get killed in the battle, then their wives will all become widows.
那如果他们这些将领啊，年纪大人都出来作战的话呢，他们的家里的老婆之后都会变成寡妇了。
And the children have no father.
那家里的孩子也就没有父亲了。So
the children have a difficult time growing up.
那家中没有父亲的话，小孩要成长就困难了。And
the result is they, because of the heads of the family are not there, the culture is lost.
那因为这些家里的长者去做占领，所以呢。 家中没有那些长辈，那就没有文化。And
when the culture is lost, then the people become irreligious.
当那个没有文化、没有文明化，人们就变得是非宗教性了。And
the result is you get unwanted progeny.
那种结果就会变成了有不想要的后代出生了。
Just like all over the world. There's a lot of unmarried mothers.
就像全世界现在有一个共通的现象，是很多未婚女子，未婚妈妈。
young women have children. Just like in Australia, for example, if a young woman has a child, then the government will support her.
在澳洲是这样，如果年轻，就是未婚有未婚妈妈的话呢，他们的政府会来资助这种未婚妈妈。
So the young woman thinks, why need to work?
所以年轻的那些女孩，未婚妈妈就说，为什么要出去工作？
Let me just find a boy, I'll have a child with them, and then I can live peacefully on my own.
就说我去找一个男人，找一个男孩，然后生小孩，我可以，然后我自己可以自己很和平的过日子。
And the government will take care of me.
那我这样的情况，政府会照顾我的。
Yeah, they give me a house, they give me some money every month.
那政府会给我房子啊，或者给我一些钱啊。
They're thinking this is a nice arrangement.
他们就会认为这是很好的安排。
I don't need a man. Husband just be a lot of trouble.
我不需要有男人，丈夫只是一堆麻烦。
And this is a situation for any young women.
这是很多年轻女孩子的状况。
But the problem is that for the children growing up, it can be a big problem.
但是这个问题对小孩的成长会有很大的问题。
One of the problems is, first of all, the children are born in an irreligious manner, so they have no samskars.
一个情况就是说，这些孩子们呢是在非宗教、在罪恶行为中出生，所以他们这个生长过程没有经过那些进化的仪式。
And so, it means that the soul which is attracted into the womb at the time of conception comes with bad karma.
就是说，这种在非宗教程序下的生出生的孩子，就是说他们在受精的时候是不恰当的情况了。那这小孩会在不吉祥的状态里面带来很多不，就是不吸引不好的业报的灵魂出生。
And that's a great handicap for the child, young child growing up, that when they have bad karma, then that means they have difficulty studying, they have difficulty fitting into society.
那这样的情况就是对小孩来讲是一种心理障碍，心理不健康的情况，就是说他在成长过程，跟人的交往还有学习的过程呢，会有很多的障碍或是困难。
So it's a problem, and many and all over the world, we see that this is a problem.
在全世界各地看到这一种问题，是真的产生了很多的问题。
No, but even 5,000 years ago, Arjuna was thinking about this problem.
即使5,000年前的那个时候，Arjuna已经想到这样的问题了。
Arjuna was thinking the wrong way about it. However, he was thinking that if I don't fight, it will be better.
但是Arjuna当时的想法是正好错误的。他想说，他不出来作战的话呢，就不会有这些问题。
Arjuna was thinking the answer is to give up work.
Arjuna 想的 答案是说放弃作战。
But Krishna is saying no, the answer is to work.
但Krishna对Arjuna说， 不是这样子，这个答案是应该出来工作，出来进行。
So Bhagavad Gita is the yoga of action. The people who were encouraged to act, not to give up action, but to be more active.
所以伯爵梵歌是一个行动的瑜伽。 不是叫人们放弃活动，而是要人们去更加的去进行活动。
But we must know how to act in the proper way.
但是我们必须要知道，要是怎么样正确的去行动。
Which means guided by sadhu, shastra, guru.
就是由这个圣人啊、经典啊，还有guru来引导。
Then you are safe.
这样子的话，你才是安全的。
So it's nice, more and more people are reading Bhagavad Gita now. We see even in Taiwan that many Chinese versions of Bhagavad Gita, people are taking an interest to try to understand these scriptures. It's a great treasure from the past.
这个是过去所传来一个很伟大的宝藏。
People are understanding that they get greater wisdom, greater knowledge from the past than they do from the present.
所以人们呢，从这里面得到更多的知识，更多的智慧。 然后呢，他们得到所以以前留下宝藏这样的智慧的宝藏。
Okay, any yes, Shubha, Auntie.
Maharaj 在说明一下关于我们怎么样来跟随灵性导师，还有经典，还有圣人他们的指导跟训示。
Yes, we need generally we need to be guided by scripture. So Bhagavad Gita is one scripture. There are many other scriptures. We're encouraged to read these books.
那一般而言呢，我们是需要有经典来引导我们，像伯伽梵歌是也是一个经典，那还有其他的经典可以引导我们，指导我们怎么样的言行。It's
important to hear these kind of knowledge from these scriptures.
那去聆听这一些经典里面的知识是很重要的。And
of course, in the beginning, we may say it's very difficult. I don't understand it, but if we we'll keep hearing it, and if we also try to understand it in the association of devotees, then it becomes easier.
那当然，最开始我们说，这个很难啊，真的不容易了解啦，很难懂啊这些的。但是呢，如果我们继续的聆听，然后在奉献者的联谊之中来聆听的话，渐渐的这个变得很容易懂。
So, Sadhu says it means the association of devotees.
那关于萨杜拉这个圣人，就是说跟奉献者的联谊交往。
And hearing from the guru, just like here in the Bhagavad Gita, we not only have the words of Krishna, but we have also the instructions of Srila Prabhupada, the teacher.
那聆听从灵性导师那边聆听呢，就是说就像说。 在《佛前梵歌》里面，不只听到 Krishna 所说的，而且有 Prabhupada 的明确的指示。So
to understand scriptures, it's nice to hear from the teachers, the gurus, and the other acharyas, and their purports help us to understand the meaning of the scriptures.
所以去从经典去了解，就是说，从一个灵性导师或圣人那边去聆听呢，是更加的容易了解，更正确。
We actually see that in the past there were many editions of Bhagavad Gita, but there were very less devotees.
我们也在看到过去呢，也有很多一个版本，这个《佛前梵歌》很多不同的版本，但是确实很少人是成为奉献者。
But once when the Bhagavad Gita, the authorized version of Bhagavad Gita, comes from a devotee, the result is that many more devotees appear.
但是被认可的这种权威的《佛前梵歌》版本的结果，就是说，去接触的研读的人是更多人成为奉献者。So
Bhagavad Gita is guiding all of us how to awaken our devotion.
所以《佛前梵歌》是在引导我们。
If we were to simply to hear Krishna, if we were simply to hear only Krishna's words, then it wouldn't be very difficult to understand what Bhagavad Gita is about.
如果我们仅仅只是听着Krishna的话语的话，我们会真的是很难去了解Krishna所说的。But
when we hear the commentaries, the purports which are given by the different acharyas, then it helps us to appreciate more the meaning, the significance.
但是我们从这些圣人啊、灵性导师们那边去聆听这些，还有这里面的要旨的话，让我们更加的对《佛前梵歌》对Krishna所说的更容易了解。And
it's important also to check against the different authorities.
那同时要去检测不同的权威也是很重要的。
For example, if we were to just to take the guru as the only authority, Now, if we're simply depending on the guru without checking the shastra and without being guided by sadhus, then we could easily get problems. The guru is not God.
Guru 不是, 灵性导师不是神,
the guru is simply a humble servant of God.
Guru 只是神的一个谦卑的仆人,
and he is meant to instruct according to the scriptures.
灵性导师他的意义就是说他要把经典的训示出来。
So when we get some instruction from a spiritual teacher, we would want to check with the scriptures to make sure that what he's teaching is in accordance with the scripture.
所以当我们从所谓灵性导师那边听到训示的时候, 我们会想要跟经典来印证对照，所以灵性导师说的是正统的。
And we would also want to check what the other devotees have to say.
同时我们要去检测其他奉献者所要说的。
There should be parallel tracks.
就是说要像平行轨道这样同时进行。
Now if you have a contradiction between one of these three authorities, then there's a problem.
那如果说在所得到的知识或训斥，在这三个权威之中，任何一项有所谓不协调或是抵触，就有问题了。So,
some people say, "Oh, I have faith. I just have blind faith in my guru. I just do whatever he says."
那有些人就说，我对我的guru完全有信心，他说的我就会完全去做，照做。
Well, that's not very good.
但这也不是很好。
You have to have faith also in the scriptures, in Krishna.
那你也必须要对Krishna、对经典有这个信心。
There is a verse which says, Yasya devi para bhaktir yata devi tata guru. But one, Tashyaiti prakityahiyata prakashanti mahatmana. That one should have faith in both the spiritual teacher and in the Lord. And then all the purports of the scriptures are revealed very easily.
好，这句诗就是说，一个人要对经典、对主有信心，这样子这些真理的描述才有意义。So
then we will ask, who do you have more faith in, Krishna or the Guru?
那我们就问你，对 Krishna 还是对 Guru 比较有信心？
And some people will say Guru, and some people will say Krishna.
有些人说对 Guru 比较有信心，有些人对 Krishna 比较有信心。
And this is wrong.
但这都错。
Because the guru is supposed to be representative of Krishna.
因为guru应该是Krishna的代表。
He is one with Krishna, but at the same time different from Krishna.
他在任务或是训示上跟Krishna是相同同一个，但是在实际上又有不同。
So we should have faith in Krishna and Guru both.
所以我们必须要对Krishna跟Guru两者都有信心。
Should be equal, not more in Guru or less in Guru, but equal.
那就要对Guru跟Krishna都一样的有信心，不能说偏移。
In the same way, we have to connect the spiritual teachers, the spiritual master's teachings to the scriptures and to the message of the other devotees.
那这个同时我们要对Guru 的教导跟经典的教导是有信心，而且跟奉献者这样传递的教导是有信心是一致的。There
was an interesting case came up a few years ago in mainland China. One lady, she said that Krishna instructed her that the Bhagavad Gita is very old now and he wants a new book and she should write it.
就是这发生在中国大陆。 有一个女士就是说，啊，Krishna给她指示说，这个《伯爵梵歌》已经太旧了，太老了，Krishna就说要新的哈，新的版本叫她写。
And she wrote a book, and she got a lot of followers.
那结果那个女士真的去写了一本《不戒梵歌》，而且很多人跟随她。
No disciplic succession.
但是她没有这个使徒传承。
Nothing to support her from the scriptures.
然后没有任何的经典上的论证来支持她的说法。
Krishna told her. Krishna spoke.
她唯一的一句就是说 ，Krishna 跟她说 ，Krishna 叫她这么做。
And so many people surrendered to her.
可是呢，还是很多人去跟着她，臣服于她。
Not very intelligent.
这样就真的不是很聪明。
This is what happens in the Kali Yuga. People are often cheating. There's the cheaters and the cheated.
那这是在卡利年代经常发生的事，就是说有想要被骗的，就有骗子来骗人啊。
And people are easily misguided, and they're often very unlucky in searching for the truth.
而且呢。 一般大众常常被误导，那对他们来讲，也寻求真理的情况变得很不幸。
They don't understand the principles of spiritual knowledge.
他们不了解灵性知识的原则。
They don't read the scriptures.
那他们不去读经典。
They don't know how to recognize a spiritual teacher or how to inquire from a spiritual teacher.
那他们也不知道怎么样去分辨什么样是叫做灵性的老师。
And they don't
不晓得去分辨哪一些是真正的经典。
And they never had any association with devotees.
而他们也没有真正的有跟奉献者联谊。
So it's important to have guidance from Sadhu, Shastra, and Guru.
所以要有经典、灵性导师跟圣人的指导引导是非常重要的。
Of course, we're talking about spiritual pursuit, not just simply our, you know, our mundane material life, but our spirit for our spiritual interest.
我们说的这个情况，特别是在灵性上的追求，而不是世俗物质的东西。Spiritual
master is not going to tell you how to invest your money.
灵性导师不会去教你怎么样去投资。We're
not going to. Spiritual master's job is also not to cure your disease.
灵性导师的工作不是说帮你治病。Spiritual
master's not a doctor.
灵性导师不是这个。
And neither is he a business financier.
灵性导师也不是你的财经顾问。
We have to understand what is the proper role of the spiritual teacher.
我们必须要很正确的了解灵性导师的职责角色是怎样。His duty
is to guide us out of material life.
灵性导师的责任是要引导我们怎么样脱离物质生活。To
take us out of this material world.
灵性导师的职责是要带领我们离开物质世界。Take
us back to Krishna.
带我们回到 Krishna 那儿去。
Any other question? The proper attitude.
就是说，怎么样是正确的态度来说，检测经典或测验灵性导师，什么样的态度才是对的？
Well, the proper attitude is inquiry. It's just like in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna said, just try to learn the truth by approaching the spiritual teacher and inquire from him.
正确的态度是说询问，就像《国伽梵歌》里面 Krishna 对阿朱那说，你就是询问哈，谦卑的去向灵性导师询问。We're
required to first of all submit ourselves. Tat vidi pranipatena. Bhagavad Gita says pranipatena. We should submit ourselves. Humbly, we should approach the spiritual teacher.
所以《不戒梵歌》也是这么说，就是
When we are just like we're reading in the evenings, we've been reading Kapila Shiksha, we've been hearing about the teachings of Lord Kapila, and Devahuti came before Lord Kapila and she expressed her condition that she was, you know, she was tired of the material existence.
那这个Devahuti呢，他是跟这个Kapila来询问，就是说 Devahuti说他已经厌倦了物质世界的生活了，那他很厌倦，他不知道要怎么办。And
she sincerely desired to have enlightenment from Lord Kapila.
而且他是很真诚的想要从主Kapila那边得到启蒙。And
she inquired from him about what is this relationship between man and women and between matter and spirit?
那Devahuti很诚恳的去向主Kapila询问，就是说，男女之间的关系是怎么样，然后灵性跟物质的关系是怎么样？
So when the questions are put like this, and they're very encouraging for the speaker.
所以当像这一类谦卑的询问的问题提出来的时候，去讲述的人会觉得很愿意来讲述分享。We
see in the scriptures, there's qualification for the speaker. Speaker has to be qualified. Audience also have to be qualified.
那我们知道呢，当在讲述者呢，他必须要有资格来讲述。 但是这个听众聆听的人必须要有资格。The
audience have to be enthusiastic and eager to hear.
这个听众的资格就是说，他必须是很热切的啊，急切的热诚想要聆听。And
they're ready to inquire. They want to know.
而且是准备好要去询问，就是说他想要知道真理。
So like this, when there's proper speaker and proper audience, then the reciprocation, the atmosphere becomes very surcharged with spiritual energy.
所以就是这样子，讲述者跟听众都是很有资格的，是很真诚的话，这样这个气氛就是很有那个充满灵性力量的。But
on the other hand, if someone is not very eager to hear, if they're simply challenging and they don't accept anything, then it's of course very difficult.
那相反的情况，如果说聆听的人呢是不想听、不愿意接受，或者是挑战性、挑衅的这样询问的话，这样情况就变得很艰难。那
Srila Prabhupada, for example, used to come and give lectures. In the beginning, he was quite willing to have questions, but after a certain point, he was not so much eager to have questions because he found so many of the questions to be foolish.
就像Prabhupada他到处去传教，最开始他很热诚的愿意，就是说有大家提问这样问答。后来到一个情况，他不太愿意有这种问答的情况，因为他发现很多人问题是很愚蠢的。
Not intelligent, not proper questions. If somebody said, why? You know, we're all sitting on the floor, why are you sitting on the big seat? Sometimes they would ask, you know,
就是有时候有人甚至问他这一类的问题。
OK, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai.